Here are 10 new shortcuts to manage photos on your iPhone. From cleaning up your screenshots and screen recordings every day, finding your new favorite live wallpaper and setting it automatically, take a photo of a book page and get key points, automatically add photos from today to a shared album, and more. Links to download all these shortcuts are in the video description, and keep your shortcuts requests coming. Another request video is coming soon. First up, maybe you take photos every day for your work or you're on a trip, and you want to be able to create a new album and move all the photos you've taken today to an album with today's date. Well, we're using an action here called Find Photos. You can search for your actions here and just search for the Find Photos action. I'm on the iOS 18 beta right now, so this might look a little different, but you'll have that action even if you're on older versions of iOS. The Find Photos action can be customized with lots of filters, but I just added date taken, is on, and then current day. Just to show you what that looks like, once you add the Find Photos action to a shortcut, just do Add Filter, tap on Album, and you'll see all these different filters you can add to the Find Photos action. We're going to be using some of these other actions and shortcuts in a moment. But for this, let's choose Date Taken, Is On, and then if you tap and hold on the space next to Is On, you can choose Current Date. So this will get all photos taken today. I'm also going to show you how you can create an automation so this happens in the background automatically. And what this is going to do is take all photos that were taken today and create a photo album, and that photo album's name is also going to be the current date. If you tap current date, you can format that however you'd like. I turned off the time format and just have the date, so abbreviated month, day, and year. And if I run this shortcut, we'll actually find an album automatically created in the background, we didn't have to do anything else, with today's date and photos I've taken. So if I go to the Photos app, and if I scroll all the way to the bottom, you see it created a new album with today's date and all the photos that I took today. Now, as you can see, this also included screenshots in that album, but if we wanted to, we could further customize these filters, tap where it says Album, and you could say Is Not a Screenshot. Then it will only add photos, not screenshots, to that album that it creates every day. Now, if you wanted to automate this, you could go over to the Automations tab in Shortcuts, hit the plus button. We'll do time of day. Now you could have this run early in the morning if you know you find yourself taking pictures at like 1 or 2 a.m. Or you can have this run every night. We'll say 11:34 p.m. run daily. We want this to run immediately. No notify when run. Hit next, new blank automation, and then search for the run shortcut action, and then search for our daily album. And if we do our daily photo album shortcut, now every day at 11:34 p.m. it's going to create a new album with today's date and move all photos to that album. Number two, you can do a similar shortcut where it finds all photos that you took today. So here's that Find Photos action, Is Not a Screenshot. So you say I added that filter, but this one adds another action after that Find Photos, which is Choose From List. Just so you know, that action looks like this, Choose From List. And that will actually allow me to choose from the photos that the first action surfaced. And then it's going to give me the option to add the selected photos to a shared album. So if I run this shortcut, you'll see I have all images that were taken just today that are not screenshots, and I can choose which ones I want to add to an album. I'll hit done, and then this view will pop up, and you can access all your shared albums here, and then add specific photos from today to a specific album. This is great if you're on like a family trip or you're traveling with friends, and you just want to quickly choose some photos every night to add to that shared album. Number three, I created a daily screenshot cleaner. So what this does is it starts again with the Find Photos action, but this finds all photos that are a screenshot and were taken today. And then there's a second action here that is just delete the photos. So let's see if this actually works. I have a screenshot from today. It's actually this one, a screenshot of my YouTube channel. There it is in the photo grid, so we'll be able to check if it actually gets deleted. Now I'm gonna run the shortcut. It'll find all screenshots from today. There is a confirmation to delete. I'll tap delete. And now if I go back to my photo library, that screenshot is gone. Now this next shortcut solves a problem that I've been needing a solution to. I don't know how many of you out there will use it. Let me know in the comments. But my preferred way to actually read books are physical books. But then you can't really highlight. I don't like marking up books, and it doesn't make it easy to actually search through parts of the book you enjoyed and you want to go back to. So I do this weird thing where I take a picture of the page, but now I just have a bunch of pictures of book pages and they just sit in my photos. Well, what I did was create this shortcut where it will allow me to select multiple photos, and then it repeats an action with each photo I selected. There's an extract text from photo that's a built-in action to shortcuts, and then I have a text block here with a little prompt for ChatGPT. It's telling it that this is the page from a book and I want it to pull out some pertinent or key information. Then it's going to get the extracted text from that photo and add it to the end of this prompt. Then I have ChatGPT app installed on my iPhone, so I have an action here where it will send this prompt to ChatGPT 4.0. And then what it does is it runs that action through every photo I had selected, it combines those results, and then it can add it to a note of my choice. So for instance, I've now created an Apple note with the title of the book I'm currently reading, which is 4,000 Weeks. I'm actually going to choose that note here in the last action, which is a built-in shortcuts action, append the combined text to that note. I'm only 3 chapters in, but it's a great book, by the way. Now, when I run this shortcut, I can choose from my photos, pictures of the book pages. I'll tap Add, and now the shortcut is going to extract the text using OCR from each one of those photos, send it with that prompt to ChatGPT, combine all that text, and then append it to my note with the book title. All right, I've finished running. Let's go over to our note and see what it did. And there's all the text from ChatGPT. It gave me pertinent quotes and key info from each of those pages of the book. And now my favorite pages of the book are summarized with quotes pulled out in a note for me to refer to. This quote especially hit me hard, thinking back to my prior work lives. The more efficient you get, the more you become a limitless reservoir for other people's expectations. Whoa. So anyway, if you like to take pictures of books like I do, that might be a good shortcut for you. And a little twist on that kind of shortcut, I have a summarize from photo. I've done something like this in the past, but I adjusted the prompt a little bit. And what this does is I can select a photo. This doesn't have to be a photo of a book. It can be any photo or screenshot with text in it. It's going to pull out pertinent information from it and show me a summary right here. So if I run this shortcut, I'm going to choose this image right here, which is actually a letter Winston Churchill wrote about brevity. It's going to OCR that text, send it to ChatGPT, and then let's see what it comes up with. And we get a nice brief summary on Churchill's letter on brevity. And there you go. All right, number 6, like the screenshot removal, you can also do a find photos action and include anything that's a screen recording. You can do date is taken and then in the last month or so. Or if you want to do a little more thorough cleaning, you can choose the last year. Then I'm going to add a second action to this shortcut. Like before, I'm going to choose from list. If I expand this, I can choose to select multiple, which I want to do. And then I'm going to add the final action, which is delete photo. That is going to delete any of the screen recordings that I choose in this choose from list action. If I run the shortcut, it's going to show me any screen recordings. I actually see some screen recordings from my Apple Vision Pro reviews. So I'm going to select some of those. I'll hit done. It'll prompt me this the first time. And now I'm going to delete all of those screen recordings in a moment. If I run this again, you'll see those screen recordings are now gone. If I want to delete another one, I'll select it, hit done. And apparently this prompt is going to come up every time for screen recordings, but I'll hit delete. And now that one's gone as well. You can try to program this into a daily automation, but you are still going to have to confirm that delete. So it might be better just to run this manually whenever you want to do some cleaning. All right, this next shortcut, again, uses the find photos action, but this time it's going to find all photo types, which is a live photo, only show me live photos that I've marked as favorite and I've taken in the last year. And then without even me choosing, it's going to get a random item from those photos and then set the wallpaper for my device with that random live photo, both the lock screen and the home screen. Keep in mind, not all your lock screens are going to be compatible with setting a wallpaper. So you might have to tap there. Let me choose my default wallpaper, non-focus mode. Let me run this again. And there we go. It worked. It set it. And I can actually preview which photo it chose here. This was actually a meetup from the last Podcast Movement conference. Okay, interesting choice. Let's actually go to that lock screen to see what it looks like. If I go in and actually tap the live part, now I'll actually get movement on that lock screen. And now you'll see when I wake up my phone, you get a little movement from that live photo, even before I unlock my device. This is a shortcut you could set as a daily morning automation, and you can wake up to a new live photo that you've set as a favorite every day. All right, number 8, like the screen recording and screenshot deletion, I have another shortcut here, and this finds all your videos where their length is greater than 20 minutes and it's been captured in the last 2 years. I choose from the list of those videos and I delete it. If you want to save some space on your iPhone, this is a great shortcut to find those longer videos and quickly delete them. There's one, I can tap it, click done, and now those long videos will be deleted from my device. All right, number 9 is kind of a two-parter. This is a request I've gotten multiple times in the comments. And so these are two shortcuts that you can program for automations. The first one is similar to one of the previous shortcuts. Create an automation that runs every day, and it will take all the photos that are not a screenshot from the current date, and that's going to save it to an album called Inbox. So for instance, let's say this runs in the background every evening. It's going to take all the photos I took today and add it to an album that I've titled Inbox. Let me go over to my Photos app, and you'll see here's my inbox. I have two photos, that Winston Churchill letter and the photo of my desk I took today. And any day this runs, it's just going to add more photos to this inbox album. So that's the first part of this process. Next, what I have this shortcut doing is it's going to find all photos from my album inbox. And then for each of the photos in my inbox album, it's going to run a repeat with each action. It's going to show me what the image is. This way I can make a decision in the next step. And then it's going to have a choose from menu. And from here, I can move that photo to another album or delete the photo right here from the shortcut. If I choose add to album, it's going to ask me which album I want to move it to, or it'll just delete the photo. And then I have another action in that add to album menu choice, which will remove that image from the inbox. This way, if you do move it somewhere, then it'll keep the inbox clean with just new photos that you've taken. So let's actually do this. It's going to run through. For this one, I'm going to move it to a different album. I'll say add to album, and I'm going to move it to the studio album. And it's going to show me the next picture, which is that Winston Churchill letter. And let's say I'm actually going to delete this photo. I'll tap delete. And now if I go to my inbox album, it should be totally free of images. And there we go. You'll see the inbox is now totally clear. The Winston Churchill letter is gone, and that first photo was moved to my studio album. And if we go to the studio album here and I scroll all the way down, there's the photo I took today. So these two shortcuts used together, you can automate the first one to add all photos you've taken in a day to your inbox album, and then run this sort inbox photos manually, move the photos to whatever albums you would like, or delete them, and you can just be organizing your photos ongoing every day. So those are 10-ish shortcuts, but I want to give you one bonus one, and this one I actually use for my movie podcast. And this will just give you an idea of some of the other actions available to you when it comes to photos. What this shortcut does is, for the movie podcast, I like creating a social media post with the movie poster. So what this does is, asks me for text, it actually searches the iTunes store for that text, which will be a movie title, gets the artwork from the iTunes store of that movie title. There's some photo actions here where you can get the height of images, resize images, and then also will overlay that movie poster onto another image in my files that's kind of like a social media frame, and then it shows it to me in Quick Look. I'll put a link to this shortcut down in the video description as well. Just to show you what it does, let's say we're reviewing the movie Gladiator. It'll show me search results from the iTunes store. Yep, the Ridley Scott movie is the one I want. Gets that movie poster, automatically overs that movie poster on the social media frame that I have saved in my files, and I can save that, share it on Instagram, do whatever I'd like with it. Just a fun little shortcut, shows how the power of overlays, resizing images, and you can do all of that in a single shortcut. So those are some shortcuts to organize photos on your iPhone. Again, leave more shortcuts requests down in the comments below. Another request video coming very soon. Subscribe to the channel and hit that like button, of course. And if you want to see some of my past shortcuts videos, like my last shortcuts request one, I'll leave it right up here. And if you want to start from the beginning with shortcuts 101, where I walk through the basics, then shortcuts 201 and automations basics, all of that, check out this playlist right here. Just watch every video in that playlist. I bet you'll find something useful. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.